on behalf of or in behalf of, call on or call in, ride on or ride in, which is the correct phrase to be used. If you are uncertain in how to use these phrases, then this video is for you. Good day, e-learners! Welcome back to this channel. In my last video, we discussed on some commonly mispronounced science terms. Today, we will discuss some confusing English phrases. These English phrases are often used interchangeably both in speaking and writing. So let's find out if you are using these phrases correctly. First in the list, we have in behalf of and on behalf of. But before discussing these phrases, I would like to thank Ma'am Ruhani Mancao for the suggestion. So in behalf of means for the benefit, advantage, or interest of in acting as agent, friend, or benefactor. This simply means that you're acting as an agent to help someone. In this sentence, you are doing something which is facilitating the fundraising to help the athletes of your school. Perhaps these athletes will be joining a competition and they will need new uniform. Since you're acting as agent to help these athletes, then the phrase in behalf of is used. Let's take the second example. Who are the agents? The agents are the local officials. What's the action? Open a new community food pantry. For whom? For the underserved residents. Here it is clear that the action done is to help someone. On the other hand, on behalf of means as the agent of, in place of, or on the part of. This simply means you are representing someone. In this sentence, the I is only representing batch 1998. Is the action done has the purpose of helping? The answer is no. It is just expressing the deepest sympathy and is representing batch 1998. So the phrase is on behalf of. What about in this sentence? Maria is representing whom? Maria is representing her parent. That is why the phrase on behalf of is used. I hope this information had helped you to distinguish when to use on behalf of and in behalf of. As a recap, when we say on behalf of, that means you are representing someone. In behalf of, that means you are helping someone. Now let's proceed to call on and call in. Call on as defined means to ask someone to do something. In Jose Carrillo's English Forum, he said that when asking speakers or presenters to go on stage or in front during programs, the proper phrasal verb to use is call on, as in, may I call on the university's president, Dr. Mario Perez, for the opening remarks. It is presumed that the person being requested to do the activity is just nearby, maybe backstage or in front among the audience. So if you are to summon someone who is just nearby at the time of speaking, then use call on. On the other hand, call in means to summon for assistance or consultation to someone who is not present or near the speaker at the point of speaking. For example, I want to call in Attorney Ramirez for a very important meeting. It is presumed that Attorney Ramirez is not around or near with the speaker. Same explanation is applied in this example. This is said to other persons simply by way of information. I hope this information had given you clarification on how to use call on and call in. As a recap, when I say call on, that means to summon someone who is just nearby at the time of speaking. When I say call in, that means to summon someone for assistance or consultation. And the last phrases are ride in and ride on. Use in when the noun is inside a small mode of transportation, such as a car. Note that we can also use in with box or bowl shapes such as wagon and canoe, though they are not enclosed. So say, ride in a truck, in a car, in a taxi, in an SUV, in a wheelchair, in a stroller, in a canoe, in a wagon, and in a rowboat. Now, depending on the type of chair, in and on are both possible. For example, in an armchair, or on a dining room chair. On the other hand, use on when the noun is on top of a small mode of transportation such as motorcycle or inside a large vehicle such as bus. So you say on a bicycle, on a motorcycle, on a horse, on a skateboard, on a train, on a bus, on a subway, on a ferry, on a boat, or on an airplane. For some modes of transportation, in and on are both possible. So you say in or on a helicopter or in and on a submarine. As a recap, use ride in if the noun is inside a small mode of transportation or with box or bowl shapes, though they are not enclosed. And use ride on if the noun is on top of a small mode of transportation and inside a large vehicle. Now it's time to assess your learning. So get a piece of paper and a pen and let's do this activity. The person riding blank a horse is my professor. What's your answer? Since the noun is on top of a small mode of transportation, the answer is on. I need to know the update of the project. Please call blank Ms. Chavez. What's your answer? Since this is to summon someone for consultation or assistance, the answer is in. Professor Santiago plans to spearhead a feeding program blank behalf of the Typhoon Yolanda victims. What's your answer? Since Professor Santiago acts as agent to help the Typhoon Yolanda victims, the answer is in. Jessica and team made sure that their parents rode comfortably blank the wheelchair. What's your answer? Since the wheelchair is a small mode of transportation but in a box type, then the answer is in. I would like to express my sincere apology blank behalf of my friends. What's your answer? Since I is representing his or her friends and not helping someone, then the answer is on. Congratulations! What's your score? Now, if you got 5, you are excellent. If you got 4, you are very good. If you got 3, you are good. If you got 2, you need more practice. And if you got 1, you need to watch this video again. There you have it, e-learners. These are the confusing English phrases that I wanted to share with you. I hope you learned something from this video. If you are new in this channel, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And if you don't want to miss out, hit the notification bell for my upcoming videos. I hope to see you all in my next video. Happy e-learning!